Hi, I'm Aaron, and I'm super excited to be here with you. Today, we're going to talk about a common problem that many Word users face: how to combine multiple Word documents into one single PDF. Now, if you work with Word files on a daily basis, you've probably come across situations where you need to merge Word files to PDF. How do you do that? And for that matter, how do you attach PDF to Word or combine Word and PDF files into one single document? Well, in this video, I'll show you easy ways to merge Word files to PDF, as well as other ways to combine these two file types into a single document, so it's easier to share, archive, or read on multiple devices. Hello again. In this segment of the video, I'll take you through a few different tools that you can use to combine multiple Word documents into one PDF. The first one is highly recommended because it offers simple ways to combine Word documents into PDF and is much more user-friendly than the other options. So let's begin with PDFelement. PDFelement is a powerful Word to PDF converter and merger that we're going to use to combine multiple Word documents into one PDF. So believe me, it can be a lifesaver when it comes to managing document workflows. So before we begin, make sure you've downloaded PDFelement for Windows. So launch it and follow the steps I'm going to show you right now. So step one, first click on the Combine PDF icon on the welcome page to open the Combine PDF dialog window. Step two, here you can drag and drop your Word files or use the Choose File button to import them. You can also use the Add Files button in the next window in case you forgot any files. Step three is to select the destination folder for the merged file on the bottom left, and then click Apply on the bottom right. And that's all there is to it. Wow, so simple, right? For users of this app, here are a couple of tips to make the process go even faster. So my first tip, tip number one, is to combine Word to PDF directly from your desktop. This operation is super easy for anyone to perform, even if they have zero experience working with file conversions. So step one is to choose a single or multiple Word files on your desktop and simply click right-click to see the menu. Step two, click on Create to PDF. And whoopee, you're done. The merged PDF can now be saved to the desktop or another folder. Tip number two is to combine Word documents into PDF as a batch process. So this method is an excellent option for power users who deal with a large number of documents and need a fast way to get the job done. So step one, on the welcome page of PDFelement, you probably noticed a batch PDF icon. So click that now. Alternatively, on the main menu after opening a file, click the batch process button. This takes you to step two when you see the create window. Drop your Word files there or use the choose file option. Step three, you can hit the apply button to convert all the imported Word documents into a single PDF file. And voila, we are done. Now, if you're an Adobe user, let's explore some steps you can follow to create the same results. So once you have Adobe Acrobat open, step one is to go to the Tools menu in Adobe Acrobat and choose the Combine Files icon. Step two, next, click Add Files to import multiple Word documents. Step three, at this point, the files are still in Word format, but ready to be converted and combined. So just click on Combine to merge them and then open the output PDF file. And finally, step four, click Save As in the main file menu to store the PDF in a local folder. Now, if you're a user of Foxit PDF Editor, you can follow this process. So first step is to go to the Combined Files or Merge PDF section on the top menu. Step two, use Add Files or drag and drop your Word documents into the application like so. And step three, you can add or remove files from the queue using the ribbon toolbar options. And finally, step four is to click on the Combine button on the right side of the toolbar here and use Save As to save the output file to a local folder. And there you have it. So for all of these, let's make a brief comparison between PDFelement, Adobe Acrobat Reader, and Foxit PDF Editor. Now, we have to admit, all of them are great professional tools, but Adobe Acrobat and Foxit PDF Editor have time-bound free trial versions. So after the initial 14-day free trial, most features do get locked and you can't access them without paying for a subscription. On the other hand, PDFelement does not place any restrictions on the free version. A watermark will be applied to output files, but you'll still be able to use the software's essential features. Right, well, now some users have asked me this question. So if I have other daily files besides Word, such as Excel, PowerPoint, PDF, and other formats, can I combine all of these different formats into a PDF with just one click like before? And well, thankfully the answer is yes, absolutely you can do this. So let's check out how to get it done using PDFelement. So once you have PDFelement open, click on the Combine PDF icon on the PDFelement's homepage. So next step, number two, just as we did before with the Batch Process Create option, simply drop your Word and PDF files into the window or use the Choose Files button to import them. And you can add even more files here with the Add Files button in the next window. Step three, click Apply once you're done and the PDF file will be created and opened for viewing, after which you can hit File and Save to store it on your local drive. And that's pretty much as simple as it gets. So there you have it. No need to worry about using multiple tools or converting half your files into one format so they can be merged with other file types. It's all very simple with PDFelement. And now for my next magic act, I'm going to show you . So first of all, why would anyone need to know how to merge PDF files into Word? Well, imagine a scenario where you're working on a Word document in Microsoft Word, but you need to bring in some text and images from an existing PDF file. So you can either figure out how to attach PDF to Word, which is complicated, or you can copy paste directly from the PDF to the Word file, which may result in some text alignment going all over the place. There's actually a better way. Step one, in Microsoft Word, just bring your cursor to where you want the PDF content to go, then click the Insert tab to bring up the corresponding toolbar ribbon. Step two, in the text section of the toolbar, select the object icon and click on Text from File. Step three, in the new Explorer window, choose the PDF from which you want to import the text and click the Insert button. And voila, the content from the PDF file will be pasted into your Word document at the point where your cursor was placed. Right, so if you just need to combine files without considering about the risks of file protection, you can consider some online solutions as well. So you may be asking yourself these questions. So can I merge multiple Word to PDF online? And what are the tools for this? Well, yes, you can, absolutely you can. And there are several great tools to merge Word documents online to PDF. So let's take a quick look at these. So the first tool is PDFEN or PDFEN. So this ready to use online tool is simple and efficient. Simply just drop your Word files into the browser tab at the PDFEN URL and click merge to convert them into PDFs and combine the content into a single PDF file. The second tool we can look at is HiPDF. So HiPDF has a Word to PDF utility. Unfortunately, it only works for single files, but to merge multiple Word docs into PDF, you can first convert your Word files to PDF and then use the Merge PDF module to combine them. And the third tool is ILovePDF. So similar to HiPDF, ILovePDF is a great online file merging tool, but it doesn't support the multiple Word files to PDF operation if you're not a premium user. You can use Word to PDF module followed by the Merge PDF tool to get the job done, however. Now, I get a lot of questions on this channel, some great questions from our users and social media followers. So let's do a quick you ask, we answer session in the next part of this video. Here are some of the questions our users have asked. Question: how do you combine multiple PDF pages into one continuous long scrolling document without separations? Great question, and you can definitely do this. The answer is just to convert the PDF into an image file and tweak the relevant settings parameter so that the page breaks are removed. Make sure you select adjoin all pages into one single image. So next question, my computer says failed to merge documents and it shows that there is a lock on the document. So what do I do? Well, answer is you'll need to unlock any documents in the queue that are password protected. So you just need to simply click on the padlock icon and enter the password to open the file. Then you can proceed with the merging process like so. Next question. So I want to be able to select several files and move them together when merging, but I don't want to move them one by one individually. So is that possible? Well, the answer is yes, it is. So in the combine window of PDF Element, you can actually select multiple files and reorder them as a block instead of one by one like so. Okay, next question. So is it possible to create bookmarks with the merge function? And answer, well, yes, when you use PDF Element, absolutely you can. So the combined PDF window has a checkbox option to create a catalog page at the beginning of the merged PDF. So this page will contain links to navigate directly to the corresponding section of the PDF file. And that's all we have time for today, but let me just say that it was a pleasure taking you through the many ways to combine multiple Word files into one PDF. So one last question, how easy was it to combine multiple Word documents to one PDF using PDF Element? Well, I'd appreciate it if you would drop me a comment to let me know down there in the comment section. So this is Aaron signing off, and please hit subscribe and the notifications bell to make sure you don't miss any of the helpful videos that we publish on this channel. Bye for now, and thank you so much for watching. See you next time.